Hi, my name's Kerry. I'm one of the guys here that help look after the animals. It's a pretty cool job around here, looking after animals from all around the world, both fish and reptiles. Speaking of cool reptiles, have a look at these guys. These are the Australian water dragons. They're called water dragons because they're normally found around waterways. You can find them running up and down the banks, hanging out in the trees above the water, or even jumping in and holding their breath, sitting underwater. Water dragons are exothermic, or cold-blooded. This means they rely on the environment around them for their body temperature. So that's why you'll sometimes see them sunbathing on a rock, but they're actually absorbing the sunlight and the heat to get going for the day. When water dragons aren't sunbathing, they could be very animated, scaling the banks, climbing in the trees, or leaping off into the water. They'll sit on the bottom of the pond and hold their breath longer than you can to hide from any predators like snakes and birds. Another way water dragons can escape predators is they have the ability to move their feet so fast they'll scoot across the top of water without sinking. Pretty unique for not having webbed feet, eh? At feeding time, they can be really active and leap down, racing over to grab their food before someone else gets it. They're an omnivore, which means they love a good bit of fruit and vegetable, but even better, they love a big juicy insect. A nice fat locust is a really good snack. Most of these water dragons were actually bred, hatched, and raised here at the aquarium.